Hello children, today we are going to start with civics chapter 2, that is secularism. You all know that India is a diverse country, and when we talk about diversity, India is having diversity even in religions. We have find the differences in religion of the people in a state, in the society, in the country and in the world. And when we talk about these differences, people, those who are belonging to different religions, either they dominate or they discriminate themselves from the people belonging to other religion. And even from time to time, we have seen many communal rights which are based on religion. And the example for that is the time during the partition of India, where we have seen a very barbaric communal right between Hindus and Muslims. When we talk about this word secularism, the word secular is added in our preamble as per the 42nd amendment of the constitution. And as we have discussed that India is a diverse country, here the people are belonging to various religions. It means all the people belonging to different religions are equal and all the religions are respected equally. Even the state does not have any authority or right to promote a particular type of religion. So in this context, we can say that secularism is the basic of Indian society, or we can say the whole fabric of our Indian society is based on the strands of secularism, and it is very important to be practiced in a democratic country. If we are not having this concept of secularism, no country can be said as a democratic country. So first of all, we'll be discussing about the meaning of secularism. Secularism means no differences on the basis of religion. All the people belonging to different communities or different religions are treated as equals, and even state cannot promote any particular type of religion. As per our constitution too, our government cannot promote any particular religion or cannot imply any policies which should promote one religion and should discriminate between the religions. A secular state is that where a state neither favors any religion nor it discriminates against any religion. And all the religion, or we can say all the citizens belonging to different religions, are equal in the eyes of law. So we can say that India is a secular state. In our country, every religion is having the right to prosper and grow. So in general terms, we can say that secularism means the religion is separated from state. It means the state and its functioning is different and it is not at all affected by the religious communities, or it cannot be differentiated on the basis of religion. As you all know, we have discussed about this concept in the previous chapter too. And to sum up, we can say secularism means a belief that no particular religion should be given importance or no people should be differentiated on its basis. Our constitution even has granted us certain fundamental rights, and these rights are granted to us so that we can protect ourselves from the misuse of powers by the government and by the dominance of one community or one religion over other. When we talk about secularism, if a country does not provide this concept, then our basic fundamental right is not being granted to us. So we can say that our fundamental right will not work out if there is no secularism in a country. So to develop in a proper manner, or if a country needs to develop in all the aspects, then it is important that a democratic country should have the concept of secularism in it. So moving ahead with the chapter, we are going to discuss about the need of secularism. As we have discussed right now, in a democratic country or in a secular state, religion is different from the state. So this is important to run the country in a democratic manner. So this is the first importance or need of secularism, that to run our country in a proper democratic manner, it is important to have secularism. If we will not give equal respect to every religion, then our basic fundamental rights are hindered. It means if we are giving fundamental rights to every citizen, then we should give respect and freedom to each and every person to prosper. Secularism even relates with the guarantee of fundamental rights to the people of country. Or we can say that any sort of dominion practice which is followed by one community over other violates the fundamental rights which are given to us by our constitution. Next need of secularism is, as we all know, in every country there are people belonging to various religions living together. So that is obvious that one community might be in majority and some communities might be in minority. In this manner, if the power comes in the hands of the majority and they start misusing their powers or the financial resources for dominating the other community, that will lead to differentiation or discrimination on the basis of religion. That's why it is needed to have secularism in every country, so that all the people should be at a common level. It is even needed for a country to be secular, because as we have studied, especially related with our country, there is one fundamental right to freedom of religion. So if a country is a secular country, it helps in granting this fundamental rights to the people, because it gives the freedom to the people to choose the religion of their own choice, and even they can change the religion if they want, and even they can interpret the teachings of any particular religion according to them. So in this manner, it even helps the people to practice their fundamental right related to the religion. Now we'll be studying about Indian secularism or secularism in India, how it is practiced. As we have discussed in the starting of chapter, that the word secular is added in our preamble as per the 42nd amendment, or we can say in 1976 this concept was added to our preamble. But even before, India was a secular country, because since earlier times the people belonging to different religions are living together in India and all are getting equal respect. So in this manner, not as per the concept, but since a long time, India is being a secular state, as all the people of all the religion are getting equal respect and all are equal before the law. So we can say that if a country is a democratic country, so it can practice secularism only when it will have such circumstances which are being followed in that country. Some of those features are that one community should not dominate other community on religious basis. Next, the people or the group of members belonging to one particular religion should not dominate or should not suppress the people, those who are belonging to other community or other religion. Our constitution even prevents any sort of inter-community or intra-community domination. Right now we have discussed about inter-community. Now intra-community means, according to a secular state, there should not be any domination by the members belonging to one religious community over the people belonging to other religious community. As we all know, India does not have any particular state religion. So even the state does not have the right to promote any particular religion and to take the freedom of people belonging to other religions. When we are talking about the dominion conditions, even our constitution try to prevent some of the dominic conditions which are prevalent in the country. So the dominion practices which are prevented by our country or by our constitution are, as we all know, India has adopted the strategy of separating religion from state, and even our government cannot promote any particular religion. We can understand it through an example. Like, as we are having different type of festivals in our country, so the government does not allow any particular religious festival to be celebrated in the government offices or in the schools. For every religious festival, holidays are being given and the people are allowed to celebrate those festivals at their homes rather than celebrating it at government places. This helps in preventing any sort of domination based on religion among the communities. Second dominion practice which is prevented in our country is that India adopts a strategy of non-interference with religious practices so that the sentiments of all the religions and all the communities can be saved. For example, as we all know, there is a rule in our country to wear the helmet compulsorily while driving a two-wheeler. But as we all know that the people belonging to Sikh religion or Sikh community, it is compulsory for them to wear a turban around their heads. So when they are wearing a turban, they cannot wear helmet. So it is not compulsory for the Sikh community people to wear a helmet. In this manner, some relaxations are given as per the religious communities, keeping in view their sentiments so that their religion should not get hurt or their sentiment should be saved. The state even has some policies of interference in some of the communal religious laws which are made by particular communities, and this interference is done so that the people belonging to same community can have the same inheritance law as other communities are getting in the same society. The state is even having the right to interfere in the community through its support. For example, the people in our country, as per the fundamental rights, they are having the right to set up their own institutions to promote their own religion. And for that, the state even provides them financial help so that they can set up their own institutions or their own infrastructures for propagating their own religions. The state even adopts a strategy of interference in any of the religion to prevent any sort of domination which was mentioned earlier. For example, the practice of untouchability, which discriminates the Hindu religion itself. It means it divides the people in the Hindu religion which are belonging to upper class and the Hindus which are belonging to the lower class. As per our constitution, the system of untouchability has been abolished from the Indian society because it is believed that it has created difference among the Hindu communities on the basis of upper caste and lower caste. So in this manner, we can say that state can even interfere in the religion if it wants to abolish any of the evil social practices which is already going on in the society. Moving ahead with the chapter, we are going to study about some similarities and dissimilarities among the concept of secularism in Indian constitution as well as the constitutions of other countries. First of all, we'll be discussing about the similarities between Indian secularism and the concept of secularism which is practiced in other countries. First similarity is, as per the objectives which are mentioned in the secularism concept in our constitution are same in the constitutions of other countries too. Even in other countries, any particular religion is not being promoted by the countries. Second similarity is related to the constitution of US. As per the first amendment of US constitution, the state cannot support any particular religion, nor it can declare any religion as the country's particular religion. It means all the religion are equal in the eyes of law. So it is same when we talk about India. In India too, the state cannot promote any particular religion. It means the concept of secularism is almost equal in all the countries, whether it is India or any other country. Next, we are going to study about dissimilarities or differences in the concept of secularism which is practiced in India and in other countries. Indian secularism is unique as compared to the secularism concept in other countries. The example of this is, as we have discussed, that Indian constitution is having a strategy that it can interfere in the religious affairs. Example was the concept of untouchability. But if we talk about American constitution, there is a complete separation between the religion and the state. Second dissimilarity is that when we talk about Indian secularism, here the state can interfere in any sort of religious matters, but the way they interfere should be according to the ideals which are mentioned in our constitution. It means whatever are the guidelines given in our constitution, following those guidelines, the state or the government is having the right or the power to interfere in any sort of religious matters to have a proper and better conditions in our society. So in this manner, we can say that India is completely a secular state, or the society in India is completely based on the concept of secularism. Because here the people are having the freedom or the right to practice their own religion. And the concept of secularism work hand in hand with the fundamental rights given to the people. Because the fundamental rights cannot be practiced unless and until we provide a secular atmosphere to the people. Every person is having his own rights. So when these rights are not being granted to the people, then we cannot say that ours is a secular country. So in this manner, we can say that if we want our country to be a secular country or a secular state, and we need to grant people the freedom to access their fundamental rights. So these two things should be managed together so that country can run in a better manner. Secularism even prevents us from any sort of dominion conditions, and even our fundamental rights are based on secular principles. But still, we can see that there are violations to each and every rule which are in our country. So in this manner, when these violations are seen, it is compulsory that law should be implemented strictly so that the people in our society can have a better standard of living, and they should have all the rights to practice their own religion and to practice all their fundamental rights. So this was all about the concept of secularism. So before winding up the class today, let us revise whatever we have studied today. So the summary of the chapter is, secularism refers to the belief that religion should not be involved in the organization of society. India is a secular state. It does not favor any particular religion, nor does it discriminate against any religion. Secularism is important for a country to function democratically. It is essential for a democratic country to be secular because it has to protect the freedom of individuals. The state can intervene in religion in order to prevent evil social practices. Our constitution guarantees fundamental rights that are based on the secular principles. So this was all about the chapter. So stay home, stay safe, and keep working.